Hello everyone. I would like to demonstrate this ONIV CCTV Connect web app. So basically, Streamlit is a Python framework that allows you to develop web applications with ease. This allows you to like convert traditional applications that you would have otherwise designed in Python, but not have had a web-based interface for. So this could either be like interfaces for machine learning models, control systems, like interface systems for robotic systems or other types of control systems, or interfaces for other applications. The great thing about web apps is that generally they're compatible with any type of internet connected device as long as it has a compatible web browser. So this could work on Android, iOS, PC, or Mac. So basically, the ONIV platform is a set of APIs that are available in most CCTV cameras that allows you to extract data, various types of data from them, and also control them at the same time. Generally, the API that we are going to use for this demonstration is the Live JPEG API. The reason that we use the Live JPEG API is that we only basically get the camera to work, like get the camera to capture the live JPEG. So basically, a live JPEG is the JPEG frame. The moment the instruction is sent, the JPEG frame that is live for that particular time. So it is a very instantaneous action. So it wouldn't require much work on the camera. Like if you were to use RTSP or RTMP streams, you'd be constantly giving work to the camera where it has to convert the raw frame into RTMP or RTSP streams, which contain a lot of overhead. The problem with this is, like, if you've got a camera that does not have a lot of processing power, sometimes this could slow down the camera, you could lose frames, or you could lose the stream altogether. So the advantage of the way we have really gone about this problem is that, like, you would only be given instantaneous work to the camera, and then after that, once you capture the frame, that is all. So what we're really doing is we're continuously sending a JPEG instruction and the camera sends a JPEG frame over. And this is like a continuous process, but the camera only works for that process of capturing the JPEG frame and not anything else. So basically, this demo only requires three pieces of information. That is your camera's IP address, your camera's username, and your camera's password. If you know your IP address, it's 192. The moment I click connect, I should be able to get two streams. So one is a pre-processed stream where there is no processing of the image as such. So there's like, you're not going to see anything in the first stream if it all works properly. Like, so it's just as how the CCTV camera sees it, right? Like if you're not to do any sort of processing. The second one will contain processed images. So basically anything that it detects from the frame, it will draw a bounding box and it will have a sort of a text description on top of it, saying what it has detected. So I think already we have got a detection somewhere saying that it has detected a boat. If we can zoom out. Okay, I think, no, that's not really a valid detection per se. So yeah, what I'll do to demonstrate this further is I'll try to walk in front of the camera and then see if this detects me really well. Hopefully you should be able to see a bounding box around me and a tag on top of it that says there's a person, right? So you'll get the idea of this once you see this demo in action. So yeah, if you just scroll down, in fact, it has successfully detected me several times. And these are the coordinates for when a person has been detected. And then hopefully if you have been looking at this particular screen, I think you should have seen the bounding box being drawn and all that. And then maybe when about in the bounding box walking with that.